Hello friends, in the previous video we learned about some patterns of square numbers. In this video we will see some examples related to these patterns. If I ask how many numbers are there between the squares of two consecutive numbers 11 and 12 which are not square numbers? So how will you solve this? You can pause the video and think about your answer. If you solve this question in the usual manner, that is, first find the square of the numbers, then count the numbers between them, that will take a long time. Here, we can write the squares of the numbers 11 and 12 in this way. We know that between the squares of numbers n and n plus 1, there are two n numbers that are not square numbers. Thus, there are 22 numbers between the squares of 11 and 12 which are not square numbers. Now, if I say that you have to find the sum of the following numbers, how will you do it? You may pause the video and think about your answer. If we again solve this question in the usual manner, it will take a long time. But if we solve it using the pattern of square numbers, it will take less time. Let's do it together. If we look at the sequence of numbers carefully, we will observe that it is the sequence of the first 15 odd numbers. We know that the sum of the first n consecutive odd numbers is n square. Thus, the sum of this sequence will be 225. See how we solved a difficult question easily with the help of the pattern of square numbers. Here, if I ask whether 81 is a square number or not, how will you verify? Yes, we can write every square number as a sum of consecutive odd numbers starting from 1. So, we will subtract consecutive odd numbers from the number 81 in their order. If in the end the result is 0, then this number will be a square number. Otherwise, this number will not be a square number. Let's verify it together. Here we observe that by subtracting consecutive odd numbers, we finally get 0. Therefore, we can say that 81 is a square number. Now tell me, what will be the next number in the sequence of these triangular numbers? Think about it. Let's solve this question together. We know that adding consecutive triangular numbers gives us a square number. Let us add them. Look at the square numbers of this sequence carefully. These are consecutive square numbers. The next square number of this sequence will be 36. This means the sum of the number 15 and the next triangular number must also be 36. Thus, we get the next triangular number as 21. Hence, the next triangular number is 21. In this video, we learned to solve questions with the help of some patterns of square numbers. In the next video, we will see some misconceptions and simple mistakes related to them. Thank you.